My name is Msimeki Nkatingi. I am the Managing Director of Min Creative Co., as well as a Non-Executive Director of Business and Arts South Africa. 20 years ago, we didn't have social media and so much connectedness because of things like the internet. So when something happened, unless it made the news or the newspapers, it was almost as if though it didn't happen. But it doesn't necessarily mean that it actually didn't happen. In 1999, a 14-year-old Valencia farmer was gang-raped and essentially stabbed 53 times before she was killed. In 2013, you have Anine Boyson, who is also gang-raped and killed. And then a month later, you have Reeva Steenkamp, who's shot 4 times and dies. In 2017, you have Karabo Mokoena, who is killed and burnt beyond recognition. In 2019, you have Uinene, who goes to a post station to collect a parcel, which happens to be next door to a police station. And she doesn't make it out alive after she's also raped and killed. The latest one is Chehofacho Pule, who is killed while 8 months pregnant and then hung on a tree by a hitman hired by her abuser. It seems as if though the names, the faces and the hashtags change, but the violence remains the same and it still continues. The reality of this is that the perpetrators are men. And we have a pandemic in this country where gender-based violence against all kinds of genders by a heterosexual, male-driven hatred, I don't know what it is, towards others, keeps going on and on and on. For the average person who's a victim of these, it's a matter of life and death. And for most men, it's just a matter of, but what if I didn't do it? Or what if I'm falsely accused? When women are asked what they would do if there were no men in the world for 24 hours, most respond by saying they would take a walk at night, they'd go for a jog, or they'd wear the clothes that they want to wear. What this makes you realize is that men have taken away the freedoms of others within society. You realize that we live in a world where not everybody shares the freedoms that heterosexual males share. You realize that we live in a world where if a man wears a dress, it becomes impossible for him to exist within a society that can accept him. The freedom of others is not a threat to your freedom. However, your freedom should not threaten the freedom of others. It seems that the biggest threat to us moving forward as a people isn't even things like COVID, but really gender-based violence. We're not just speaking about violence of males versus females, but we're speaking about violence against genders that don't subscribe to what people consider their gender norms. So if somebody identifies as queer or as transgender or anything that a heterosexual male usually doesn't agree with, their life too can be in danger. We have to make it a point to fight, resist, and educate against any form of violence and against any kind of infringement on the rights and freedoms of those that live in this beautiful country of ours. You have no right over anyone else's body. You have no right over anyone else's freedom. You have no right over anyone else's lifestyle, who people choose to love, how people choose to love, and how people are. At the end of the day, everyone needs to mind their own business and work on themselves. And what you do as a man is that instead of breaking down, you build up. Another thing that a lot of men don't take accountability for is reprimanding other men when they can see and hear that they're doing wrong. What this does is that it makes you an accomplice in something that is very dangerous. The moment you see somebody infringing on someone else's right, in your place of privilege, of not being discriminated against, it's your duty to stand against that and to call it out for what it is, which is absolute nonsense. We need to live in a world where people feel like they can be themselves everywhere they are, whether it's in the comforts of their homes or whether it's in public spaces. This thing of people not feeling safe when they go out, because men can kill you. This thing of people not feeling safe when they go home because the men at home can kill you needs to stop. 16 days of activism against gender-based violence isn't necessarily to say that in those 16 days there shouldn't be any gender-based violence. It's an awareness campaign to remind us that throughout the entire 365 days, there shouldn't be any gender-based violence. Don't just be an ally with your voice, but be an ally with your actions, because actions speak louder than words.